name is Deacon Lemmy Simmons. I bring you greetings from Amazing Grace Missionary Baptist Church. Our pastor is Reverend Curtis Wooten Sr. Our first lady is Brenda Wooten. Our church motto is, "This is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it." Before we go into our scripture reading and prayer, I would like to give you some encouraging words on today. I want you to remember that God does not break promises. He breaks chains. All right. Our scripture reading on today will come from the 128th number of Psalms, verses 1 through 8. And it reads, "Blessed is everyone that feareth the Lord, that walketh in his way. For thou shalt eat the labor of thy hands. Happy shall thou be, and it shall be well with thee. Thy wife shall be as a fruitful vine by the sides of thy house. Thy children like olive plants round about thy table. Behold, that thus shall the man be blessed that feareth the Lord. The Lord shall bless thee out of Zion. Thou shalt see the good of Jerusalem all the days of thy life. Yea, thou shalt see thy children's children, and peace upon Israel." May the Lord add a blessing to the reader, the hearer, and doer of his holy word. Let us clear our minds. Let us bow and go into prayer. Dear gracious and eternal Father, Father, we thank you for sight of another day, Father. Father, we just thank you and we are grateful, Father, for another day's journey, Father. We are glad. Father, right now, on today, we give thanks to you, Father. Father, for shelter. Father, for food. Father, for finance. Father, for peace and protection. Father, we thank you, Father, for our church family, Father. Father, we thank you for our church home. Father, we thank you, Father, for everything that you do, Father. Father, we thank you for your wisdom, your knowledge, your grace, your mercy, your peace, and your protection, Father. Father, we ask right now, Father, that you would bless the shepherd of our house. Father, that you would bless our first lady, Father. Father, that you would bless their family. Father, we ask that you would bless our church family. Father, bless our church home. Father, we ask right now, Father, that you would bless those who you have appointed, Father, put in leadership, Father, that you will bless them with courage and the strength, Father, and bless them with good decisions, Father, each day. Father, we thank you, Father, right now, and we ask you, Father, that you would bless us, Father, as we go into the different shops, Father, and businesses, Father. Father, that you would protect us, Father, from any evil, Father, and block out any evil, Father, any harm, Father, that someone wants to do to us, Father. Father, we pray, Father, right now, Father, that you would go, Father, behind prison walls, Father. Father, that you would change minds and change hearts. Father, the prisons are filling up fast, Father, and only, Father, you can stop that flow. Father, we pray right now, Father, that you just change the men's minds, Father, and change their hearts, Father. Father, that you will show them a better way, Father, in life, Father. Father, we ask that you will go into the schools, Father. Father, that you will bless our educators, Father. Father, that you will bless our students. Father, that it will be a place of learning, Father, and a place of peace, Father. Father, we also ask right now, Father, that you will bless our first responders, Father. Father, our doctors. Father, our nurses, Father, that you will give them courage. Father, and give them strength, Father, to make it each day, Father. Father, we thank you, Father, that we have been able, Father, to survive, Father, a year of this virus, Father. Father, we thank you, Father, for the protection, Father, allowing us, Father, just to make it through this, Father. Father, we pray, Father, we just thank you, Father, for what you're doing, Father, the progress, Father. Father, we pray, Father, that you will continue, Father, to heal the land of this virus, Father. Father, we ask that you will bring peace upon this earth, Father, prosperity, Father, to your people, Father. Father, we thank you for all that you do, Father. These things I pray and ask in your Son Jesus' name. Amen.
I am the creator. I am the maker of the universe. I am the one who spoke into nothing and all creation heard. I am he who has all power in my hands. And if you believe on my word, you can stand.
Good morning. It is indeed a blessing to be in the house of the Lord once again, being able to give praise to the Almighty God. I first want to thank Pastor Boone for an opportunity to give the word, but I want to thank God for just being who he is and doing all the things that he's done in our life. If you'll give me a moment, I won't be before you long. I'm going to give you what God has given me, and I hope it bless your soul. I want to start off by giving a prayer, and then we'll go forward. Heavenly Father, we come, God, as humble as we know how, God. Thanking you for being so good, God. Thank you for the activities of our limbs, God. Thank you for food on our table. Thank you for all the things you have done for us, Heavenly Father. Heavenly Father, we ask you to forgive us for any sins, God, that we may have committed, God. Heavenly Father, we just want to ask you to bless our church family, Heavenly Father. We want to ask you to bless our pastor and our first lady, Heavenly Father. But Heavenly Father, I ask that you remove me out of the way, Heavenly Father, and use me. Stand up in me, God, as you never stood up in me before, Heavenly Father. Remove me out of the way, Heavenly Father, and use me, God. Heavenly Father, I just want to say thank you for all that you have done and all that you're about to do. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. If you will give me a moment, I'll be coming from Exodus, the third chapter, verses 11 through 15. Again, it's Exodus, the third chapter, verses 11 through 15, and it reads, "And Moses said unto God, Who am I that I should go unto Pharaoh, and that I should bring forth the children of Israel out of Egypt? And he said, Certainly I will be with thee, and this shall be a token unto thee, that I have sent thee. When thou hast brought forth the people out of Egypt, ye shall serve God upon this mountain. And Moses said unto God, Behold, when I come unto the children of Israel, and shall say unto them, The God of your father hath sent me unto you, and they shall say unto me, What is his name? What shall I say unto them? And God said unto Moses, I am that I am. And he said, Thus shalt thou say unto the children of Israel, I am hath sent me unto you. And God said moreover unto Moses, thus shalt thou say unto the children of Israel, the Lord God of your father, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, has sent me unto you. This is my name forever, and this is my memorial unto all generations. If you will give me a moment, I want to talk about, don't forget that I am that I am. In the beginning of chapter 3, Moses was leading the flock to the backside of the desert. And while he was doing this, he encountered an angel that was in a burning bush. Moses saw that the bush was on fire, but was not being burnt up. So he stopped to look and see what was going on. And while he was stopping and looking to see what was going on, God called out unto him. And when God called out unto him, he gave Moses a task. He wanted Moses to go tell Pharaoh to go. He wanted Moses to go to Pharaoh and tell him to let his people go. And that brings us to where we are now, verse 11, where Moses was taught having a conversation with God. And Moses had to figure out, who am I to go tell somebody to let your people go? And when I came to that scripture, I asked myself a lot of times when I was called into the ministry, who am I to go out and worship and witness for God? Who am I to try to bring somebody else unto Christ? Who am I? What's so important about me that they're gonna listen to what I have to say? And just as God did with Moses, he had to tell him, I am God. I'm the God of Abraham. I'm the God of Isaac. So, in general, I was just like Moses. I had to figure out what was so important about me. But then, when it all boiled down, it's nothing important about me. I was just a vessel that God was using. And just like me being a vessel, that's what Moses was. God used Moses to bring his people out of bondage. See, sometimes we're all caught up on who is bringing the message or who is doing something, but it's not necessarily about who is doing what. It's all about who sent them to do it. And so he had to let Moses know, when you go, don't worry about who you are. Just go and know that I'm with you. And while I'm with you, you tell them, the God of your fathers sent you. The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac. Just let them know that I am sent you. And as I began to read, I was trying to figure out, what does I am? What does that really mean? I am. And I just sat and I thought for a minute. I am could be a meaning of things. I am could be a healer. I am could be a protector. I am could be a savior. And that's exactly what God is. He's a healer. He's a protector. He's a provider. He is anything and everything that we need him to be. So when he told Moses to tell the people, I am sent you. I am the Almighty God. I am all powerful. That's just what he is. Anything in your mind that you can think of or that you need him to be, he is just that. See, some people need him to be a healer. The woman with the issue of blood, she needed him to be a healer. And that's exactly what he was for her. He was a healer. He didn't have to touch her. She touched the hem of his garment. And because she believed in the I am, she was healed. The man that was blind, he wanted to see. He needed God to heal his eyesight, to let him be able to see. And because he believed in the I am, he was able to see. See, it doesn't matter what you need God to be. He's just that. And he wanted us to know, don't forget that I am the I am. That means if you need me to be a healer, I'll be a healer. If you need me to be a provider, I'll be a provider. See, just like Daniel that was in the lion's den, he needed some protection. And God was just there, his protection. See, we go out day to day, and we don't know what's out there in store for us. So we need God to protect us along the way. So when we step out, the I am steps up. When we walk out of our front door, we don't know what's out there to happen. But because we believe in the I am, God Almighty, that means we believe that he's going to protect us throughout our day. Some people don't, we don't get up day after day thinking, okay, we're going to have an accident, or I'm going to have a heart attack today, or I'm not going to have food to eat today. We believe in the power of the Almighty God. We believe that he's going to heal us. We believe that he's going to protect us. We believe that anything we need him to be on a day-to-day basis, that he is. And so when I read this text and this scripture, I got so happy because I understood that God was letting us know that I wasn't just the I am back then. I'm the I am today. I'm going to be the I am tomorrow. I'm going to be the I am forevermore. I am a healer. I am a protector. I am a provider. And that right there, that's good for me. Because I know that I got somebody that's looking out for me. See, I ain't always been right. I ain't always did the right thing. But because my mom and my grandmama knew that I am and they prayed for me, I was able to reap the benefits of them knowing that I am. But all today, I can tell you, I ain't got to wait on mom and them to pray no more. I ain't got to wait on grandma to pray no more. I can pray for myself because I began to know that I am. See, we get caught up in trying to figure out when God tells us to do something. We always got to try to figure out, well, how they gonna take it? What they gonna say? You know, I ain't always been good, God. I ain't always did the right thing, God. But God had to let them know. Don't worry about that. When you go out and you do what I called you to do, or what I told you to do, it's going to be all right. Because I already done opened up their ears. I already done opened up their heart so they can hear. And they can know that it's me that's talking through you. So because I am that I am sent his son Jesus to die for our sins, we're able to be happy and be thankful that we know that I am. See, I know that I am as a healer because he done healed this old body of mine. I know that I am as a mind regulator because when my mind wasn't right, he fixed my mind. I know that I am to be everything that I need him to be. I know him to be a protector because on my day-to-day journey, when I leave out my house in the morning, he protect me until I come back. So I'm not telling you that the I am can be just I am. I'm telling you what I know and what I believe for myself. See, the I am is the almighty, powerful. He's the first and not the last. He's the beginning and not the end. He's not the end, just the end. He's the beginning also. See, that's what people go wrong sometimes. They think about it and well, they say, well, he can do this time and he might can do this time, but see, he don't want you to think that he can do it this time and can't do it that time. He wants you to understand that I am the I am. That means I can do it whenever I get ready to do it. When you need me to be a healer, you just gotta believe. When you need me to be a protector, you just gotta believe that the I am gonna come and take care of you. And I know him to be a savior. See, just like in this story, he saved the people out of he saved the people of Israel out of Egypt. And see, the I am didn't stop there. He did the ultimate saving. He sent his darling son, Jesus, to die up on the cross for you and me. Say, the I am is a savior. Because he saved me. And I know that if he can save me, he can save you too. All you have to do is trust and believe. Know that he's able and he's capable of doing any and everything you need him to be. I am the I am. See, we forget that he's all powerful. Some of us forget that he knows everything. Some of us forget that he was a healer, that he is a healer. Some of us forget that he's a protector. But some of us know without a shadow of a doubt. Can't nobody tell us that he's not a healer. Can't nobody tell us that he's not a protector. Can't nobody tell us that he's not a mind regulator. Because we done been through it and we seen it for ourselves. Anything that you need God to be, he can be. I'm a prime example. As I said, when I needed him to be a mind regulator, he regulated my mind. I didn't really understand that my mind was messed up. But because of some of the things I had been through, I was just going through the motion. I used to play church. I used to go every Sunday. Until the Lord touched my heart for real. And when he touched my heart and my mind for real, I began to know him differently from what I thought I knew. See, I knew him, so I thought. But then I really got to know him. I understood that I could go to him for myself. I understood that I could have a relationship with him. And oh, when I got my relationship with God, it ain't nothing that I can't do. Because I know without a shadow of a doubt that God is right there with me. I used to second guess myself. What they gonna say? You know, you ain't always been the best you that you could be. You ain't always want to treat people right. You ain't always did the right thing. But when I got to know that I am, when I felt and had my encounter with the I am, the person that I used to be, I'm not that person anymore. The things I used to do, I can't do them anymore. And it's all because of the I am. He's important, guys. If you don't know nothing else, get a relationship with the I am. Get a relationship with God. Learn Him. Let His thoughts become your thoughts. Let Him direct your path. Let Him use you, no matter what somebody else say. When you go out, be bold with it. Let Him show up and show out in you. You walk that walk and you talk that talk. You be an example of what you're trying to get somebody else to be. You can't be doing one thing and trying to tell somebody else something to do something else. They got to be able to see it in you. Be able to talk about the I am. Because just like He was the I am back then, He's the I am today. If I leave today, He's still going to be the I am for somebody tomorrow. So let the I am, God Almighty, show up and use you. Go out and talk about the I am. Let somebody know, I am that I am. I am what you need me to be. Help somebody else experience I am. I didn't understand at first why my topic was don't forget that I am. But He had to help me to help you understand. I am that I am. I am powerful. I am almighty. I can do anything that I want to do, when I want to do it, how I want to do it. I can use whomever I want to use. I'm so glad that the I am sent His Son. I'm so glad that the I am show up and visit me and help me to go get through things that I never thought I would be able to get through. It was nothing but God. So remember, if you don't remember anything else today, remember, I am the I am. God telling you, I am. I can do anything that you need me to do. I can be whatever you need me to be. I am. I am the I am. Don't forget that I am the I am. I'm a friend when you're friendless. I'm a mother when you're motherless. I'm a healer in your time of sickness. I'm a provider when you're in need. I'm a savior. Everything that you need, I am.
If you would like to continue connecting with the Amazing Grace Baptist Church Ministry, we ask that you comment, click the subscribe button, and turn on post notifications on YouTube. Also like, share, and follow us on Facebook. If you would like to make a prayer request, please join us for our weekly teleconference line where we open with a prayer and proceed with a study of upcoming Sunday school lessons, as we like to call it, Sunday School on the Move. Feel free to join us on Wednesdays from 5 until 6 p.m. Central Standard Time. You may join by dialing 701-802-5210 and enter the access code 294586 followed by the hashtag symbol. If you would like to sow a seed into our ministry so that we may continue to be a blessing, you may do so through Cash App at $GraceAmazing1. That's $GraceAmazing1. Thank you for tuning in with us, and we hope that you have a wonderful week.